Good morning, Tuesday, December 17, 2019, 7:47 a.m. Pacific Time. Thank you, God, for this day and your word, Lord. Psalm 81, sing aloud unto God our strength. Make a joyful noise unto the God of Jacob. Take a psalm and bring hither the timbrel, the pleasant harp with the psaltery. Now try to think. Try not to think of Sunday only. Try not to think inside the box. Try not to think, oh, this is for Sunday. No, try to think like be in the present right now, okay? Take a psalm and bring hither the timbrel, the pleasant harp with the psaltery. Blow up the trumpet in the new moon, in the time appointed on our solemn day. Tomorrow's not here, yesterday's gone. For this was a salute for Israel and a law of the God of Jacob. This he ordained in Joseph for a testimony when he went out through the land of Egypt. Try not to think inside the box of religion. Try to think outside the box of religion. Try to think of this as life and life more abundant, okay? This he ordained in Joseph for a testimony when he went out through the land of Egypt, where I heard a language that I understood not. I removed his shoulder from the burden. His hands were delivered from the pots. This is deliverance right here. Thou callest in trouble, and I delivered thee. Yes, Lord, thank you. I call in trouble right now to deliver us, to deliver me, to deliver our president. Some people might be resentful for me dragging the Word of God and the Bible and God into politics and our world right now. But you know what? God's tired of not being a part of it, okay? This is why we have a mess. This is why we have the mess we have, okay? So, thou callest in trouble, and I delivered thee. I answered thee in the secret place of thunder. I proved thee at the waters of Meribah, Selah. Well, what about Jesus is coming? Yeah, Jesus is coming. He also said, occupy until he comes. How about this deal. Well, don't put your religion on me. I'm not putting my religion on you. Okay? This is fact. God is God. Okay? God is God. Sorry. Not sorry. I proved thee at the waters of Meribah, Selah. Hear, O my people, and I will testify unto thee, O Israel, if thou wilt hearken unto me. There shall no strange god be in thee, neither shalt thou worship any strange god, little g. I am the Lord thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Hallelujah. Open thy mouth wide, and I will fill it. I'm trying to do that, Lord, you know. But my people would not hearken to my voice, and Israel would none of me. Lots of excuses. So I gave them up to their own heart's lust, and they walked in their own counsels, okay? Oh, that my people had hearkened unto me, and Israel had walked in my ways. I should soon have subdued their enemies and turned their hand against their adversaries. The haters of the Lord should have submitted themselves unto him, but their time should have endured forever. He should have fed them also with the finest of the wheat, and with honey out of the rock should I have satisfied thee. You know what? God doesn't have a problem with us just living our lives and having a regular life. Going to a job and working hard and making money and taking care of your family and taking care of yourself with a job and just having a car and enjoying driving that car. He's not against that, okay? He's not against that, okay? At all. He just would like to get some glory out of it. You know, just give him glory. Just be thankful. Just be simple in life. And thank him. And we worship you, Lord, right now. I lift up politics. I lift up the impeachment of our president. I bind it in the name of Jesus. I bind this wickedness from these people that are just make up stuff continually, just have made stuff up from the very beginning. It's all lies. It's all lies. Everything you see, all the hate against our president on TV, because I don't watch it anymore. I used to watch CNN just so I know what the enemy's doing. Well, CNN shouldn't be my enemy. Okay? CNN shouldn't be my enemy. But if they are feeding me lies, now I never put that label on them like fake news is the enemy of the people, but it really is. So I don't watch it. I choose not to watch. I choose to do my own research, which you need to do your own research, okay? We can all be little journalists. We can all do our own research and be little journalists and get the news, the truth out there, okay? That's why I read the Bible. That's why I read the Bible. That's why I don't come with it like a sermon, a three-point sermon. Now, whatever, if that's your deal, whatever. But, you know, I like to read the Word because the Word of God is full of power. And it's God, okay? And He's tired of being on the sidelines. He's tired of getting blamed for things. The devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I come to give life and life more abundantly. Abundant, Jesus said, I take authority over the devil right now in our homes, in our lives. I bind you, Satan, from our bodies, from our minds, from our country, from our neighborhoods, from our officials, in Jesus Christ's holy name. I bind you, Satan, from the schools and the kids and all the protesters out there that are whatever they're protesting. I bind rebellion from all of us in Jesus' name. Father, I pray for a good day. I pray you'd bless our president. I just pray for him just to be just held in the palm of your hands, Lord, from the evil liars out there, the coup, this continual coup against him. I bind it in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for a great day. Thank you for health and healing, not just health, but perfect health. Not just health, but perfect health. That's the word the Lord gave me today. Perfect health. Perfect health. And miracles to get that perfect health if need be, for the elderly to have health, for their children, the caregivers of the elderly, to have health. Wow, wouldn't that be neat if we just needed less doctors? Oh, we'll still have doctors, but you know that we wouldn't have to rely so much on the healthcare system because we're just supernaturally healthy. Wouldn't that be neat to have for our world and our society? What's wrong with that? That's why I can't just confine myself to prayers over me and mine. I have to have it for everybody. Okay? Sorry. Sorry. Not sorry. Lord, help us, God. Help us, Lord. And give us your peace, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Peace, be still. Thank you, Father, for protecting people from tornadoes today and every day, from hurricanes, from floods, from drought, from accidents, from global warming and climate change. Lord, temper it down, Lord. If there's any of that, you could supernaturally fix it in a second. I'm serious, people. Where is our faith? When Jesus comes back, he said, will I find faith on earth? What's our problem? Why can't we have faith for these things? Okay, so I'll get off of here now. I pray that you'll start having faith. God is good and the devil's evil. Okay, learn who God is. God is a good God, okay? And he's not full of nonsense, okay? Now I'm going to just be quiet here, okay? I'll just let the word speak for itself, okay? Read the New Testament. Read Galatians. Don't invite Christ into your life and then go into religion in that sense. Go ahead and go to church. Be faithful to church. But Pastor, don't put a trip on the children of God. Don't put a trip, and please feed the sheep. Feed my sheep, feed my lambs, the Lord said. Feed them. We need more than just baby food, okay? There is a heaven and there is a hell. Come on. Come on, guys. It's not about just don't smoke, don't drink, and don't go with girls who do. It's like you're sitting on the pews of your church and you're looking down at the whole of society. No, those people, Jesus came to die for all of us. Okay? So now I will quit talking. Now I'll be quiet. Have a great day. God bless.